In the previous video, we introduced the low-power stereo amplifier BRU3P based on TPA3116. In this video, we will demonstrate step-by-step how to use the BRU3P. As we all know, for an audio system, the essential components are the audio source, amplifier, speakers, and power supply. Since the BRU3P supports Bluetooth wireless audio connection, let's demonstrate the Bluetooth connection for the audio source after connecting the speakers. If you don't want to use Bluetooth input, you can also use the 3.5mm line input interface to connect MP3 players, smartphones, or computers for audio input. Now, let's proceed with the speaker connection. This is the speaker output interface of the BRU3P, which uses industrial-grade phonics terminals for connecting the speaker cables. It's very convenient. You can see that the board provides silkscreen labels for left negative, left positive, right negative, right positive. Left negative is used to connect the negative terminal of the left channel speaker, and left positive is used to connect the positive terminal of the left channel speaker. Similarly, right negative is used to connect the negative terminal of the right channel speaker, and right positive is used to connect the positive terminal of the right channel speaker. Simply connect the corresponding wires, and it's done. Isn't it simple? The wiring is now complete. Next, connect the 12 volts power supply, turn it on, and if the power indicator light is on, it means the BRU3P is working. If the Bluetooth indicator light is blinking, it means Bluetooth is not yet paired. Now, let's connect Bluetooth. Once the Bluetooth is connected, the indicator light will stay on. Now you can play music. If you found this video helpful, please kindly consider liking, sharing, or leaving a comment. Thank you for your support and valuable feedback.